Hey, this is Puneet back again, and in this video we will looking into three options that can save you a lot of time while working in Excel. And let me tell you, I personally use these tips every single day while working in Excel. So let's get started. Alright, so the first option is about using custom lists. So custom list is basically a predefined list of values that you can save in Excel, and then you can use those values just by entering the first entry from the list. So for example, if I type and then if I drag this cell up to the row 16, I'll get the rest of the entries from this list. So this list is basically a list of names, and the first entry is the first name that I can use as a header. So rest of these 15 entries are the first name. So in this way, you can predefine a list that you want to use frequently in Excel. So you don't need to enter those values again and again, and you don't even need to copy paste values from somewhere else. You simply need to enter the first entry, and then you can drag and drop that value up to the rows where you want to enter the values. Now let's see how we can create these custom lists. So here I have this small data set, and I want to convert all of these columns into custom lists. So the first thing is to go to the file tab and then more, and then click on options. And from here I need to go to the advanced and drag it down to the end, and then click on edit custom list. As you can see here, we have a few custom lists that are already you have by default in Excel. So when you enter Jan, J-A-N, and then you drag it down up to the 12 rows, you'll get the name of the months, and in the same way you can get the name of the days as well. And here you have two different ways to create these lists. The first is to entering values manually into the list entries, and the second is to import values from a range of cells. So here I'm going to use this button to import a range. So the first is the column A, and then click on import. So here I have this list of custom values here, and again the second list, import, and then third, import, and then fourth, import, five, and sixth, the last one. All right, so right now I have six custom lists here, and I'm going to enter these lists into a worksheet simply by using the first entry from the list. Now, even if you delete this data from here, those entries will be intact, and you can use those entries anywhere in Excel. So for example, if I want to insert first name, so I'm going to use the heading first name, the first entry from the list, and then I need to drag it down. Yes, and now if I want to enter gender, I need to use the first value from the list and then drag it down. And if I need email, I'm gonna enter email and then drag it down. A custom list in Excel for the data that you frequently use every day while working in Excel. Alright, so the second option is to use Flash Fill. You might be aware of this option, but you're not using it. So it's a small reminder for you to use this option more frequently while working with data in Excel. So here I have this three columns of names: first name, middle name, and last name. So what I want here, I want to combine these values from three cells and want it in a single cell. So I'm going to enter the first entry. And then I'm going to use the shortcut key Control plus E. So it gives me the combination of all three cells for all the entries that I have in the columns. So in the same way, if I want to extract names from these email IDs, so I'm going to do this for first entry manually, and then I press the shortcut key Control E to get it for rest of the entries. And now if I press Control E, it gives me the names from the rest of the entries. So you can use this flash fill option whenever you dealing with messy data and you don't want to use heavy formulas to clean that data. Now this third tip is quite useful for people who are into data analysis and people who actually use pivot table a lot. So what happens is, when you insert a pivot table, you go to the insert tab and then click on the pivot table button. Now from here, there's a small checkbox that says add this data to the data model. So when you click on this and click OK, and then you create a pivot table normally the way you create it. Now with this, you get an option in the pivot table analyze tab, and then in the refresh drop down, you get this option connection properties. Now when you click on this properties, so you get this option to refresh your pivot table after a specific time. So let's say if I want to refresh my pivot table after every 1 minute, so I'm gonna enter one here and then click OK. And now I'm gonna go to the data. So I'm gonna delete some of the entries to see if this option actually works. So right now the total I have is 25173, and the total that I have in the pivot table is 25183. So there is a difference of 10 quantities. So let's wait for a few seconds. So it refreshes itself after every 1 minute. So in this way, you can set a timer, for example, for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, the time, whatever you want. And especially helpful if you deal with a lot of updation in your data. So friend, that's it for this video. I hope you found this video useful, and make sure to subscribe to this channel because I'll be coming out with a lot of cool Excel tips and tricks and tutorials in coming weeks. And don't forget to share which Excel tip you most liked from this video. And I'll talk to you in the comment section.